In this video, we'll create one EKS cluster based on new AWS Graviton 2 processors using Terraform. And another one is identical based on AMD EPYC processors. For the test, we'll create a Golang application based on the FastHTP library, deploy it to Kubernetes and expose it within VPC using a private Nginx ingress controller. Then we'll run a load test using one of the best load generating tools, K6. We'll use Prometheus and Grafana to measure the number of requests coming to the application, CPU usage of the containers using CI Advisor, overall CPU usage of the cluster using Node Exporter. And finally, I'll show you how to measure the cost of your infrastructure by pulling EC2 tags with corresponding instance type labels. AWS claims that Graviton 2 processors deliver up to 40% better price performance over current generation M5 instances. But they somehow forget to say that M5 is not current, it's previous generation. Right away, we can discard the 40% number. The current generation is M6. Let's compare the price by using AWS calculator. For example, M6G extra large instance costs you around 15 cents per hour to run. You can pull other current instance types from here as well. We'll look at the US East 1 region. Extra large type includes 4 virtual CPUs and 16 GB of memory. The next instance type from the current generation is M6A extra large. It is based on AMD EPYC processors and it costs only 11% more, not 40%. The last one is M6i extra large, which is based on Intel Xeon scalable processors. This instance is 22% more expensive than Graviton 2. So far, we don't see 40% in savings. Well, maybe they 40% faster at running applications. Don't trust them, test instead. To simulate CPU load within the app, I generate a private RSA SSH key, then extract the public component and return it to the client. Typically, in a similar workflow, the client generates a private key and sends to the server only a certificate request. The server signs it and returns back a valid certificate. Now, to build Docker images for a different architecture, you use a platform flag. You can pull my images if you want to reproduce the test. They are public. To create EKS cluster based on Graviton 2 processors, you just need to update AMI_type to IRM64. That means that all other components, including monitoring stuff, have to be cross-compiled as well and support IRM architecture. If you want to assign custom tags to your EC2 instances, you need to create a launch template and use tags there. Later, we can pull them from Prometheus. To get EC2 labels in the Prometheus, you don't need to use service or pod monitor. Instead, you must create additional scrape config and make sure to assign Amazon EC2 read-only access policy to your service account. You can find the source code in my GitHub repo. The link will be in description. Let's go ahead and run the test. On the left-hand side, we have IRM Graviton 2 processors, and on the right-hand side, AMD EPYC processors. Both applications receive even amount of traffic, around 3 and 4 requests per second. Now, what is surprising is that Golang app deployed on Graviton 2 processors shows much higher CPU usage, around 45% compared to AMD processors, with only 12% on average. To confirm, we also pull node level metrics to calculate overall CPU usage across the cluster, which is around 25%, and for AMD 64, it's only around 10%. On the bottom graph, we have two EC2 instances. Each of them costs $3.70 per day to run, and overall cost, not including the EKS master plane and network data transfer, is $7.39. AMD is slightly more expensive, 11% more, $8.29. There are certain use cases for Graviton 2 and specific applications that can really benefit from using IRM processors. But we typically deploy hundreds of different applications to Kubernetes with different requirements. So at this point, I'm not going to use it in EKS clusters yet. Based on this test, it's even more expensive than AMD processors. I have a playlist with other benchmarks that you may find interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.